Vsauce, Kevin here. Let's split a pizza. I'll eat one half and you eat the other. I'm gonna be using a laser guide and a protractor to make sure that it's perfectly mathematically equal, so that no one is complaining that one of us got more pizza than the other one. Okay, here we go. There we go. All right, let's just get this cutting board out of the way. Perfect, these are two exactly equal halves, so grab your slices. All right, I know that it doesn't look like it, but we can prove this mathematically. But before we do that, let's analyze how pizzas are traditionally cut and how pizzas can be infinitely cut. Pizza is usually cut right down the center through its diameter and then cut again at a 90 degree angle perpendicular to the first cut. Two more cuts bisect each 90 to a 45 to make 8 equal slices. That feeds 4 people or 2 people equally, and maybe 3 if one of them just isn't as hungry. But what about cutting one pizza to feed 13 people? Or 31? Slices won't work. We need monohedral disc tiles. By cutting the pizza into a pinwheel, you can get 12 identically shaped wedges. Monohedral tiling means every tile is the same shape. In 2015, mathematicians Joel Hadley and Stephen Worsley found you can create infinite families of monohedral disc tilings by subtiling forever. The actual math proofs on this get rather complicated, but basically there's no mathematical end to the pattern of pizza wedges that you could make. But obviously dividing up a real pizza this way for little Billy's birthday would be impractical. The pizza that I cut, however, is the same exact method pizzerias use every day. I just moved the center. Divisors of a circle was a problem proposed by L.J. Upton in 1967 and solved in volume 41 of Mathematics Magazine, challenging readers to show that alternating divisions of a circle with four lines converging on concurrent point O add up to half of the circle. Michael Goldberg solved Upton's problem without using calculus. In 1994, a follow-up piece in Mathematics Magazine explained how this problem demonstrates a fair way to split up pizza, and the Pizza Theorem was born. If a pizza is divided into 8 slices by making cuts at 45 degree angles from any point in the pizza, then the sums of the areas of alternate slices are equal. That's why if we top alternating slices with green and yellow peppers, it becomes clear that we have 2 equal halves. We can do the math, but a proof without words is considered by many to be the highest, most elegant form of proof. And our proof is in the pizza. We'll label our pizza slices A through H, and then we'll represent each slice as 2 equal shapes. We'll clone the 4 smaller slices, while the 4 larger ones will be reduced to make up for that duplication. They'll be weird shapes, but they'll be equal. We'll label them with a capital letter and a lowercase letter to differentiate which slice is yours and which slice is mine. So here's A, here's B, this is C, D, E, F, G, and finally, H. So the large slices G, H, A, and B are divided into 2 equal wedges, and the small slices F, E, D, and C are duplicated within the pizza, proving that we split our original pizza perfectly for 2 people. This will work regardless of the concurrent point on the disc, or pizza. Here's a wonderful proof without words visualizer created by Christian Lawson Perfect, where you can move the interior point and instantly see the different slices that fulfill the pizza theorem. The most delicious theorem of all time. What began as an obscure math problem dividing a circle in Mathematics Magazine has continued to be refined and reimagined 50 years later, which is impressive no matter how you slice it. And as always, thanks for watching. This pizza's 3 days old.